Hey everyone, welcome back to Vintage. Last week I was talking about The End of Eddie by Edouard Louis. Fantastic comments from people. Thank you so much for those. I really, really do appreciate them. Lots of interest about the book, particularly around its themes of homosexuality, homophobia in France. He is an amazing guy. He was actually just over in the UK doing some publicity for the book. It was great to get a chance to speak to him again. I shared the interview that I did with him in the vlog last week, but we've now been able to capture him on the Vintage podcast. So I'm going to put another link down below, which is going to take you to the webpage of the podcast. However, if you're watching this video straight away on Friday, the second part of the podcast in which Edouard Louis features will not be up there just yet, but it will go up at the weekend. The first part of the podcast is there, however. I will come back to that in a second because we're going to talk about that. First of all, I had two copies of The End of Eddie to give away. So the two lucky winners of that are Robbie and Holly M. Congratulations, both of you. You will find my email address at the bottom of this video description. Send me your postal addresses and I will get copies of that book off to you as soon as I can. Now, I mentioned the podcast. We had so much good stuff in February, and because we love you, we decided to split it into two podcasts. So in part one, you can hear James Lasden talking about The Fall Guy, which I've already spoken about here on the vlog. A link will appear up here. And John Burnside talking about his new novel, Ashland and Vine, which is the book that I'm going to talk about today. In the second half of the podcast, you can hear Edouard Louis talking about The End of Eddie and Ross Raisin talking about A Natural. All of these books are fantastic, and I really recommend listening to both of those podcasts because all of those authors are really, really, really interesting. So many fantastic themes that we were able to talk about with all of these books, sort of particularly masculinity with Edouard Louis and Ross Raisin. Ross's book is set in the world of football, has a gay footballer, so there's the ideas about sexuality, physicality, the love of the game, the love of the family around you, the love of the football family, all sorts of fantastic stuff. And as I said, Edouard Louis is just a joy to talk to. He is so, what's the word? Just wears his heart on his sleeve, and his writing is so important to him. It really comes through when he's talking about it. He often gets very emotional, and you can just tell that he really means it. He's an artist, and that's obviously always great to see. All of these writers are. John Burnside, that we're going to talk about today. You know I love John Burnside if you've watched any of my videos. More links will appear up here with videos I've done in the past. I just think he's an amazing writer. He writes poetry, he writes prose, he writes fiction, he writes memoir, he writes reviews in newspapers. He does it all brilliantly. He's a disgustingly talented man. And I love his books because they are often dark and complex and interesting. They're often set in either the sort of the wilds of nowhere or the Arctic Circle or the sort of industrial landscapes of the British Isles. They draw on myth and folklore. And that's why I was surprised when I heard the title of his new book, Ashland and Vine. Very American sounding. Then I saw the cover, American flag. And then when I actually got to read the book, here I was in America, which is not what I expected. And this is because he's done a lot of travelling in America and he had this burning sort of desire to write something about a period of American history which has been not sort of erased but has been mistold to people. And he wanted to kind of set the record straight. And this is based on his travels and based on a lot of research that he has done. The way that this book works is that a young filmmaker student called Kate is sent off by her boyfriend to basically knock on doors around their neighborhood. And the idea is that she speaks to the person who lives there. They tell her a story about their life, and then she goes back and she relates that story, what she can remember of it, to her boyfriend, Laurits, who films it. And this is the film project that he's working on. However, one of the doors she knocks on, that she's not actually supposed to knock on, it's not on the list, but she sees the house and she knocks on the door, belongs to a woman called Jean Culver. And Jean can spot that Kate is a semi-alcoholic, and rather than agreeing to her project, she makes a sort of a deal with her, which is that if she stays off the booze, she can come back another day and she will tell her a story. And if she stays off the drink for another day, she'll tell her a bit more of the story. And then the next day, she'll tell a bit more. And it's all about keeping her off the alcohol, getting her coming back and telling her more of her story. And this is how Jean's story is related through the book. It's a very satisfying way of receiving a story. And so it's a bit like a sort of Scheherazade setup. And through this manner, we hear about Jean's life. And we're looking at America post-World War II, through the 50s and 60s, into that very interesting countercultural sort of moment in the 60s and the rise of a group called the Weather Underground. If you don't know who they are, you can Google it, but I would really recommend that you listen to John Burnside talking about it on the Vintage podcast. Not because I'm just trying to plug my podcast, but because he is so, so fascinating about it. Anybody who has read American Pastoral by Philip Roth, another one of my favourite books, one that I've already, again, spoken about, here's another link, will know that that book deals with the same period and the same story. It's about a father discovering that his daughter is part of this kind of domestic terrorist group. And so I asked John whether he was sort of aware of that book, obviously, when he was writing this one, and of course he was. And in fact, in many ways, he wrote it as a response to that book, because he thinks that that book gets it all wrong about who these people were who were planting bombs and doing domestic terrorism in the US, what their motivations were, and what they were actually up to. And that's what he's trying to do with this book, is to sort of set the historical record straight, but also to tell the story of this wonderful woman, Jean Culver. You find out about her life, you find out about her love, and the things that she can't admit to herself, and so that even whilst telling her own story, there are parts of it that she's too scared of. And we are slowly, slowly going to find out about those things as Kate hears her story and does a bit of sort of digging herself. It's just, I mean, partly because of having had the chance to speak to him about it in a bit more detail, it's so much better than I thought when I first read it. And it, when I go back to it now and think about it, there is just so much in there. And therefore, having been very surprised when I found myself in America, I'm so pleased that he's written this book, because it's sort of, it has, I wouldn't say it's ruined American Pastoral for me, because that's still one of my favourite books ever, but it has made me think about it in a completely different way. And this is all about, ultimately, about people knowing their own history. Jean Culver knowing her own personal history, but Americans in particular knowing their history. And many people in the Midwest, where this book is set and where John Burnside's done a lot of travelling, people don't have any interest in their history. They're interested in their Bible, and that's about it. And these are the people who have voted for Trump. And so Burnside is very aware of the fact that if people know their history, then that might actually be the thing that might change their minds about certain things. And in the world that we live in today, that feels like a very important thing to be thinking about. So that's one of the other reasons why I love this book. Anyway, I'm not going to waffle on anymore. As you can tell, I liked it. I have two copies to give away. If you're interested, make sure you're subscribed, leave a comment below, and I will not be able to pick two winners next week, because next week I'm on holiday. Yes. So I won't be here, but I will have a vlog, because again, I love you. I've got many good, you know, good books to talk about. So there will be a vlog next Friday. Don't worry. I just won't be able to announce any winners. And when I come back the following week, there will be another vlog, and I'll be announcing two lots of winners. How does that sound? Good? Great. Anyway, that's all for this week. I will see you next week. Take care.